It seems like there will be once again a limited availability of PlayStation 5 consoles. Stay tuned. Ladies and gentlemen, how nice you have found your way to my channel. Here I am talking about the latest and still to be released games and technologies. Consider leaving a like and even subscribe if you don't want to miss any videos like this anymore. Let's go. Even though Sony reported a while ago that they were already preparing PlayStation 5 consoles and that there will be enough consoles for launch, according to reports from various sources, in first few months Sony may be able to produce a maximum of around 6 million PlayStation 5 consoles for the global market by the end of March 2021. If you want at least some kind of comparison, Sony had sold around 60 million consoles of the PlayStation 4 worldwide in about a year. And if you think about this, even back then, the PlayStation 4 was sold out everywhere for almost a year. As soon as some PlayStation 4 consoles appeared somewhere, they were sold out immediately. The biggest challenge for Sony is the cost and of course the current situation around the world. The PlayStation 4 went on sale for around $400. While it has been speculated a lot lately that the PlayStation 5 may get released with a similar price, now it doesn't seem to be the case anymore. According to rumors now, the PlayStation 5 will be around $500 to $550 due to more expensive components. However, this would be hard for Sony now to get through with this on the market, especially not if Microsoft offers its Xbox Series X cheaper. The new price is speculated to be around $450. Sony would make a loss on every sale with such a price tag, but that's nothing new and would not be so uncommon in the gaming industry. After all, the real profit comes from selling games later. Later, the PlayStation 5 should be able to be produced with cheaper components and optimized manufacturing processes at lower cost. At the same time, Sony would also like to continue to sell the PlayStation 4 and the PlayStation 4 Pro to new customers in the year-end business. There are still unknown things about the prices. Microsoft will be still offering a cheaper and less powerful console in their Series X lineup. And since it seems now that Sony has no plans to offer a PlayStation 5 Pro at launch, it will be hard for Sony to push the PlayStation 5 in a higher price range. The former high-ranking Xbox manager Albert Pennello has expressed on Twitter his appreciation for the PlayStation 5 gamepad, saying that there are some expensive design elements in the DualSense. Apparently, he is talking about the manufacturing costs. It still remains to be seen what the final price of the PlayStation 5 will be, but if I had to guess, it won't be more than $600 at maximum. A more realistic price would be somewhere between $400 and $600. Sound off in the comments what you think the price will be. And as always, thanks for watching, guys.